A Sissonville couple accused of human trafficking and forced labor of adopted children, including two teenagers who were found locked in a barn in Sissonville. Well, they're back in jail.
Now, during their arraignment this afternoon, Judge Mary Claire Akers significantly increased the bonds for Gene Whitefeather and Donald Lance. Anna Saunders joins us live in the studio tonight with the reason. Anna?
Dave, Gina, before setting their bonds to $500,000 cash each, Judge Akers said she has never seen an indictment quite like this, and that not only alleges the trafficked black children, adopting them from shelters and foster care, forcing them to work, but that they specifically targeted them because of their race.
Jeannie Whitefeather and Donald Lance came in on their own for their arraignments, but left in cuffs after Judge Mary Claire Akers set their bonds at $500,000, more than double what they had already paid.
So I don't think I've ever seen an indictment like this in all of my time. It alleges human trafficking, human rights violations, the use of forced labor, human rights violations specific to the fact that these children were targeted because of their race, and their use as basically slaves from what the indictment alleges, along with human trafficking and neglect with serious risk of bodily injury or death. I don't find the bond to be sufficient.
Whitefeather and Lance were first arrested last October when a welfare check turned into the discovery of two teens apparently locked in a shed where investigators said they lived in deplorable conditions behind the Sissonville home. One other kid was found inside the house and two others were not home, all adopted by the couple. The indictment brought more than a dozen new charges against them, alleging human trafficking and forced labor, also civil rights violations, as investigators believe they targeted these children specifically from a shelter because they were black, forcing them to work as slaves. Whitefeather and Lance were originally in Washington State, and it is alleged they brought the children with them to Sissonville when they moved.
Counts 9 through 12 allege the use of forced labor, which I read as slavery.
Bond was initially set at $200,000 cash, and they were both able to post it. Prosecutors have said in a new complaint for forfeiture, the couple sold a $725,000 80-acre ranch in Washington State and sold their Sissonville home to post bond. And they believe both of these properties were paid for through trafficking. That will be decided in a separate court matter, but because of this, prosecutors say they found discrepancies in the financial affidavit Lance filled out for a court-appointed attorney, leading to a new charge on his indictment.
Some of the information on his face is inaccurate.
Lance had to fill out a new affidavit today as the two were taken back into custody.
Now, the next time these two are scheduled to appear in court is for their scheduled trial in September. Prosecutors noted there are volumes of evidence in this case for all sides to go through. Now, in terms of the bond issue with how the original bonds were paid for, that is to be worked out at a later date. Live in the studio, Anna Saunders, Eyewitness News.